Friends, today we will take up the study of air cycles. Air cycles, or they can also be called as thermodynamic cycles of gases. Cycles of gases. What is this? What is thermodynamic cycle of a gas? Let us say, I take a gas at some initial condition, condition 1. Now this is its volume, I will call that as V1. This is its pressure, P1. From here, we take it to condition 2. That is, there are changes in its volume. Volume has become V2 and pressure has become P2. That means it has undergone a thermodynamic process. From 2, if I take it to another condition, this is 2, 3 is another thermodynamic process. Then, if I take it to 4, this is another thermodynamic process. If I take it to 5, this is another thermodynamic process. And then if I return back to point 1, condition 1, then we say that the gas has completed a thermodynamic cycle. We say the gas has completed a thermodynamic cycle if it has undergone a series of thermodynamic processes and returns to its initial condition, then it is said to have undergone a thermodynamic cycle, completed a thermodynamic cycle. So if they ask what is a thermodynamic cycle or what is an air cycle, they call it as air cycle because we are taking the gas considered is air, the gas taken is air, so they are also called as air cycles. So if they ask what is an air cycle, if air is taken at some condition in a cylinder and if it is made to undergo a series of thermodynamic processes and then it returns to its initial condition, then we say that the air has completed one air cycle, that is called a cycle. Now in these air cycles, they are classified into two types. One is reversible cycle, and the other one is irreversible cycle. Now here I have taken air at this condition 1. It has undergone a series of thermodynamic processes and it has come to this condition again. Now if it is possible to go back like this 1 to 5, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 1. If it is possible to go back 1 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, then the cycle is called as a reversible cycle. If that is not possible, if it is not possible to trace back the route that we have come forward, then it is called as irreversible cycle. Now, to have a reversible cycle, all the processes that are there in the cycle must be reversible thermodynamic processes. Now, reversible thermodynamic processes are only two, that is isothermal process and isentropic or adiabatic process. These two are the reversible processes. So, if a cycle has only these two processes and practically exact isothermal and exact adiabatic process cannot be achieved, so we do not have, practically it is not possible to have a reversible cycle. Almost all cycles are irreversible cycles. Now why we should study these cycles is, these cycles, the IC engines are designed on the basis of these cycles. IC engines work on air cycles. That's why we have to study air cycles before we actually study the IC engines. They have to be studied. Now, practically every engine that we have, except the Carnot cycle, all other cycles are irreversible cycles. They cannot be reversed, and the Carnot cycle cannot be achieved practically. It's only a theoretical cycle, but that is a cycle which is most efficient cycle. If it can be constructed, it is the most efficient cycle. So that is why we have to study that cycle. The force, you have to study four air cycles. They are Carnot cycle, which is not a practical cycle, then Otto cycle, OTTO Otto cycle, or it is also called as constant volume cycle. Then we have diesel cycle, or it is called constant pressure cycle. Then we have dual combustion or semi diesel cycle. So these four cycles are prescribed in our study. This is a theoretical cycle. These are practical cycles. All engines working on spark ignition, that is petrol engines and gas engines, work on Otto cycle. All light diesel engines work on diesel cycle or constant pressure cycle, and all heavy diesel engines work on this cycle called dual combustion cycle. Now we make certain assumptions in these cycles. What are they? Assumptions in air cycles. Assumptions made in air cycles. Assumptions means we are assuming something which is not true. Practically, which is not true. See, the first assumption that we make is, suppose this is an engine working on some cycle, based on some cycle. We are taking air into this from the atmosphere. It undergoes a series of thermodynamic processes there. Then it is discharged from here and again it is taken back. That means the cycle is closed cycle, which is not true. This is the first assumption that you make. First assumption is that the cycle is a closed cycle. It's not an open cycle. But practically what happens? We take atmospheric air and it is discharged into the atmosphere through the silencer. So we are assuming, which is not true, that the cycles are closed cycles. Then we are assuming here that all processes, we are assuming second that the working substance, that is air, working substance does not undergo any chemical change. It undergoes only physical changes during the cycle, which is also not true. During the cycle, then we assume that the cylinder in which the operations are taking place, the processes are taking place, that is a insulated material, no heat passes out from that or no heat enters into that, which is also not true. So like this, we make a set of assumptions which you are supposed to know. They can be asked in the examination. They can ask what are the assumptions made in the air cycles. That will be asked. Next, they can ask you to explain these cycles with the help of PV and TS diagrams. So first, I will take up the Carnot cycle. For Carnot cycle, the PV diagram comes like this. You have an isothermal expansion. then adiabatic expansion, adiabatic isothermal compression, adiabatic compression, 1, 2, 3, 4, which is not possible. One isothermal, one adiabatic, one isothermal, one adiabatic process, one after the other, which it is not possible to have isothermal and adiabatic processes one after another, because one is to be done very quickly and the other to be done very slowly. For this, the TS diagram for Carnot cycle will be like this. Isothermal means temperature is constant, isothermal heating process. So this is T1, then 2, 3 is adiabatic. Adiabatic means it is vertical line because entropy remains constant. Then it comes to 3, 3, 4, 4, 1. This is how, this is called T3, this is called T1, this is called S3, this is called S1. S1 and S4 will be same, S2 and S3 will be same, because this is adiabatic process. These two are isothermal processes. Adiabatic process, this is isothermal cooling, this is adiabatic compression, that is adiabatic expansion, like that. This is isothermal heating, this is adiabatic expansion, isothermal cooling, adiabatic expansion. Now these are the, this is the working. There are four operations, four processes. 1, 2 is isothermal heating, 1, 2 is isothermal heating process, 2, 3 is adiabatic expansion process, 3, 4 is adiabatic isothermal cooling process, and 4, 1 is adiabatic compression process. There are four processes in this cycle, but practically that cannot be achieved. But this cycle gives you the maximum efficiency of all the cycles. This one gives the maximum efficiency. That's why we study this, we have to study this. Now here, how to calculate the efficiency? The efficiency is calculated like this. Efficiency in any system is output by input. That is, it's a measure of what we are getting back out of what we have given. What we are getting back is output, what we have given is input. Now what we give is input is heat. We are giving heat, heat supplied or heat absorbed, it is called heat supplied, heat absorbed, anything you can call. This is work, work done during the cycle. Output is work, we are getting work, we are giving heat. So work done by heat supplied is what we call efficiency. Now the work done during a cycle will be heat supplied or heat absorbed minus heat rejected, heat rejected divided by heat absorbed. The difference between heat absorbed and heat rejected gives the work done during a cycle. Now no heat is transferred in this process. Here Q is 0, here also Q is 0. In an adiabatic process, we have discussed earlier that heat is neither absorbed nor rejected. Now heat is absorbed in isothermal heating and heat is rejected during the isothermal cooling. Now the area under 1, 2 means this one. The area under 1, 2 gives me the heat supplied, heat absorbed. Heat is absorbed during process 1, 2, that is isothermal heating process. Heat is absorbed. Now that will be equal to area under 1, 2, area under 1, 2 on TS diagram. Area under TS diagram gives heat supplied or rejected. Area under PV diagram gives work done. Always you remember that. Now this will be, because this is a rectangle, it will be T1, that is the highest temperature during the cycle, into this one is S3 minus S2. S3 minus S2, because it is a rectangle, length into width gives you the area. So this is the heat transferred or heat absorbed during the process. No heat is absorbed or rejected in 2, 3. Heat rejected during the cooling process, which one? 3, 4 is again area under this, that means this area, that is T3, T3 into S3 minus S2, that gives you heat rejected. If you substitute that in that formula, in the formula, in that formula, efficiency is heat absorbed. Heat absorbed is T1 into S3 minus S1 minus heat rejected is T3 into S3 minus S1 divided by T1 into S3 minus S1. Now, in the numerator, take common factor. S3 minus S1 is the common factor, into T1 minus T3 will remain here, divided by T1 into S3 minus S1. This can be cancelled, so you get T1 minus T3 divided by T1. Or it can also be written as 1 minus T3 by T1. This way also it can be written. This will give the efficiency of Carnot cycle. The air, it is called air standard efficiency or theoretical thermal efficiency of a cycle. For all cycles, this is common. Efficiency is equal to heat absorbed minus heat rejected divided by heat absorbed. Second is the Otto cycle. I have already told you that all spark ignition engines, engines in which the ignition takes place due to spark, that is we give an electric spark. So, you know, petrol engines and gas engines work on this Otto cycle. They are spark ignition engines. This is also called as constant volume cycle. Constant volume cycle. Why? See, if I draw the PV diagram for this, the PV diagram will be like this. This is P, this is V, volume. Now, first, the whatever we have taken inside the cylinder, that is what we call charge. In a petrol engine, we take a mixture of air and petrol here. This is V1, this is P1, this is P1, this is V1. Now, this is compressed in a cylinder at by adiabatic process. This is adiabatic or isentropic process 1 to 2. Then this is, this stroke is called as compression stroke. Compression stroke, the gas, that is the charge, is getting compressed. Now when we reach this point, the spark plus plug gives the ignition, it ignites the charge, and the burning, the combustion of fuel takes place at constant volume. That's why it is called as the constant volume cycle. And after the combustion is over, the gases expand, the burnt gases expand, that is the power stroke. And this is again adiabatic process, and here it will be swept out of the cylinder, that is during exhaust. So again, this in cycle has four processes. 1, 2 is adiabatic compression. 2, 3 is constant volume process. 3, 4 is adiabatic expansion. 4, 1 is constant volume process. Here no heat is absorbed or rejected. Q is zero here. Q is also zero here. Heat is supplied during this process. This is constant volume process. Q is absorbed. Q2, 3. The heat absorbed during this process is MCV into T3 minus T2. T3 minus T2. And in 4, 1, heat is rejected. heat rejected will be equal to MCV into T4 minus T1. That is because in these two processes work done is zero. So because work done is zero, the heat absorbed or rejected will be same as the change in internal energy. That is the formula for change in internal energy. Mass into CV into difference in temperatures gives you the change in internal energy here. This is the change in internal energy here. Now, this is heat absorbed, this is heat rejected. This minus this divided by that will give you the efficiency. The efficiency, we can prove it as, it can be proved as 1 minus 1 by R to the power of gamma minus 1. By substituting this and simplifying it, we finally get the air standard efficiency of Otto cycle as 1 minus 1 by R to the power of gamma minus 1, where R is called the compression ratio. In this formula, R is known as the compression ratio. That is V1 by V2. Now, see, for example, if you have this, if I take this as the cylinder, this is the end of compression stroke. This is the beginning of the compression stroke. Now, the V1 is the volume inside the cylinder at the beginning of the compression stroke, and V2 is the volume at the end of the stroke. So the volume inside the cylinder, this volume is suction volume or swept volume, that is the volume swept by the piston, plus the clearance volume. This volume is called as the clearance volume, that is the gap between the piston and the cylinder head at the end of the compression stroke. This volume is known as the clearance volume. This volume is called as the swept volume. So it will be swept volume divided by VC plus VC, whole thing divided by VC gives you the compression ratio. Now, VS is swept volume or stroke volume. Swept or stroke volume. It will be pi d square by 4 into L, where d is the dia of the cylinder, L is the stroke length in meters. So that will give you the volume in cubic meters. VC is the clearance volume. If that is in cubic meters, this also should be in cubic meters, or both can be in one unit, any one unit. This will give you R. Lesser the value of R, greater will be the efficiency. But from practical point of view, we cannot make, if the compression ratio is infinity, that is clearance volume, if you make it zero, that is if this piston comes and touches the cylinder head, then this is zero, then R is infinity, then 1 by R will be zero, you will get 100% efficiency, but that is not possible practically. So these are the formulae. Gamma is ratio of specific heats. Ratio of specific heats. We know that the value of gamma for air is 1.4, even if it is not given, we can assume it in a problem. Okay. This completes the Otto cycle.